We're now passing through the Rothschild Square on the way to King David's tomb, and the building that we're looking at was built in the middle 1800s by the Rothschild, Baron Rothschild, for the Russian immigration during that period of time. And in this square, in the 1947 takeover by the Jordanians of the old city, this is the last refuge of the Jews when they were all captured. Now approaching Zion Gate, which is the place in 1967 where the Jewish nation re-entered Jerusalem after the Six-Day War and came back and returned to the old city of Jerusalem in the Kotel. You notice all the bullet holes on the gate here. This is where the Israeli army fought their way back into the old city and made that final penetration to liberate the old city and bring it back into Jewish hands. The area that we're in right now, up on top here, we're looking out on, up until 1967, this was as close as the Jewish people could get to the Kotel, to the Western Wall. And looking out here, from here, we'll see that it's a very special place to me. It's the place that I got married 22 years ago. And coming downstairs from here, we'll see that we're entering now the tomb of King David. This is the place that famously people come to read Tehillim and to speak in the memory and the merit of David HaMelech. And now we're standing here reading Tehillim in the tomb of King David. Shalom and welcome to the Holy Land of Israel. Today, we'll take you around the city of Jerusalem, a place filled with thousands of years of Jewish history. I'm standing now near the Broad Wall, which was the outer wall of the city of Jerusalem, believed to be built around 700 before the Common Era by King Hezekiah, a direct descendant of King David. Now we'll go to the more modern walls of the old city. This is Jaffa Gate, a main entrance to the old city through the walls which surround it. These walls were built by the Ottoman Emperor Suleiman the Magnificent in the 16th century and fell into disrepair over the centuries. After the miracle of the Six-Day War, when Jerusalem was returned to the Jewish people in 1967, the massive task of restoring these walls were completed, as it mentions on this plaque, on the 10th of Tevis, 1970. That is exactly 2,556 years to the day the walls which we saw earlier were breached by the Babylonians. For the first time in more than 1,900 years, Jews once again controlled the old city of Jerusalem and its very special walls. The Cardo, the old Roman road, built in 6 CE. Cardo was a main street that had two colonnades, two storefronts on both sides with a large street running through the middle of it. This particular Cardo ran from the Damascus Gate in the north to the Zion Gate in the south and crossed the entire length of the city. The Cardo itself was 12 and a half meters wide, and as I mentioned, flanked by two covered porticos which were used for pedestrians. And the main street was like we have right now, was a roadway used for the chariots and the animals, horses and such. The height of the pillars that we were looking at generally ran about 5 meters tall. That's about 15, 20 feet tall. And a few of them were found in place during the excavations, and some of these pillars were reconstructed. They were found broken and lying on the ground and were built up recently to copy what was actually here.
A 10-minute walk into the Old City brings us to a synagogue with a long and glorious history. The great Torah commentator, Rabbi Moshe Ben Nachman, known as the Ramban, came to Israel in the 13th century in an effort to vitalize the Holy City, which was decimated by the Crusades a century earlier. He founded a synagogue on this very spot. Here's a reproduction of the famous letter of the Ramban sent to his son, detailing the proper qualities or midos the person should conduct themselves with in their daily life. Although it was destroyed and rebuilt over the centuries, the main elements remain, and they are these magnificent marble pillars. These pillars are at least 700 years old, but some say they are actually from the Holy Temple. They've borne witness to Crusader, Tartar, Ottoman Turk, British, and finally renewed Jewish rule in our holy city of Jerusalem. And the synagogue is still in use today by the local population.